Glory, hallelujah. The Lord is good and his mercies endure forever. Today I pray that the glory of God will shine in your life and God will make a way for you. God will teach you his ways in the name of Jesus. You will not go astray in the name of Jesus. God will make you to go according to his plan and according to his will for your life. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Amen. This is Joseph Adenunga, the pastor of Prevailing Church. I'm here with the word of life to encourage you and to motivate you in the word of God. This is the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. Today, I am talking on the topic, the consequences of trusting in man. The consequences, or let me call it the danger of trusting in man. The danger of trusting in man. You see, the Bible says in the book of Jeremiah chapter 17 from verse 5, he said, cursed be the man that trusts in man. He shall be like a heat in the desert. He shall not see when good is coming. You see, God forbids that we human beings trust in other human beings. And it is one of the most convenient things for us to do as human beings to put our trust on another human beings. Many of us, consciously or unconsciously, we live our lives by putting our trust in human beings. And it is very, very grieving to the heart of God. That is why the Bible says in the book of Psalm 121, he said, I will lift up my eyes unto the hills, from whence cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord that made the heavens and the earth. You need to learn to trust in the Lord with all your heart. Because when you trust in a man, you shift focus from God. The Bible says that anyone that trusts in man, you know, his heart is very far from God. Hallelujah. And that is why the Bible says in the book of Psalm again, he says, send us help from above, O Lord, because vain is the help of man. You see, it is very, very important for you to understand the need for you to put your absolute trust in God alone. I have also, you know, made that mistake even in my life and even in my ministry. When anything goes wrong, there are some people in my ministry that I call, that I ask help from them. I don't even need that to pray. I thought at that time that I didn't need to pray about my needs, since I have some people who could meet those needs. So I just asked them and they do it. But after some time, I began to realize that some of the help that these people do, sometimes it goes again. Like, for instance, I may lose those things and those things may not even last, you know, because, you see, I was looking to man. So God is angry when you look to man, especially if you're a minister of God. You must learn to look only unto God. Looking, the Bible says in the book of Hebrews chapter 12 verse 2, it says, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. You see, when we look unto man, at that same time, we are not looking unto God. You know, anytime we are looking unto a man, our hearts have departed far from God. That is what the scripture says. And God is not happy when we look to man. Because the Bible says that man, he can die at any time. And if you put your trust in him, you are grounded. You get grounded, you know. So don't do it. Don't put your trust in a man. I have done it. It doesn't pay. You see, you don't put your trust in a man. And put your trust in God. God will supply your needs. The Bible is, but my God shall supply all your needs according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. You see, because when we put our trust in a man, God will cause some things to happen in our lives that will humble us. You see, and God will always humble that man. When he loves that man, and that man is putting his trust in another man, God will there's something God will do that will humble you, that will bring you back to God. So, today the message is, don't look unto man. In fact, the Bible says in the book of Isaiah chapter 31, it says, woe is anybody that look for help in Egypt. Egypt is a type of the world. When you are looking into the world for your help, you are looking for help in the world. You are looking for help among people that, you know, that maybe they may even be Christians, they may even be the people of God, they may even be a pastor. When you look unto them, you are not looking unto God. God demands that we put our trust absolutely in Him, absolutely in Him. You know, in the book of Psalm 1, when he began to, you know, so he said, but his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law doth he meditate day and night. Hallelujah. When you put your trust only in God, God will cause men and women to favor you. God will cause men and women to give to you. You see, when God will cause even people who don't like you to favor you. Why? Because you are putting your trust in God. But with the moment you put your trust in a man or in men, then God cannot work. I found out in my ministry that when I put my trust in men, you see, I don't see more of the move of God, of surprise givings and surprise blessings. So let us look at this message today. I want you to think about it. Is there a man or a woman that you put your trust in? Remember, when you do that, you are not putting your trust in God. So from today, it is time to repent. It is time to look unto Jesus. The Bible says they look unto Him and their faces were not ashamed. When you look unto Him, He will bless you. You will not be ashamed. I'm going to stop there. Thank you so much for listening. I'd like you to rebroadcast this. Let somebody get blessed by this. And I know God will bless you in return. Thank you so much. This is Joseph Adenunga, the pastor of Prevailing Church, signing out and saying, be blessed and remain blessed.